So for the fourth hour today, I want to take a lot of calls. I've been listening to the calls over the last several days, and you callers have been amazing. Your information is outstanding. In fact, this phrase, a global 9/11 event, that came from a caller. I regret I don't know that caller's name, but that was a call that came in, and it's absolutely right. This is a global 9/11 style event taking place right now. Now, where Alex is absolutely correct is that this is engineered. This is a human weapon, or a weapon against humanity. This was released on purpose. Now, there's debate about who released it and why, but it was in a Chinese lab. That much is clear. At least that's what we currently believe. But it was engineered using technology that was funded by Obama and allowed to be transferred to China by Obama-connected individuals and universities that were taking money from China and things like that. So Alex is absolutely right, in my opinion, that this is an engineered global event. However, where I think a lot of Trump supporters are currently wrong is in thinking that it's a hoax because the left-wing media is talking about it. So yes, the left-wing media lies all the time. They lied about Trump, you know, for the last 3 years. They lied about Russia. They lied about impeachment. They lie about Alex. They lie about everybody. They lie about me. But it doesn't mean that they're lying about this. In fact, occasionally, even the lying left-wing media will collide with something that's true. They are using it to try to bring down Trump. But that doesn't mean there isn't a virus. It doesn't mean that PCR genetic testing isn't real. I've even heard that argument from some people across the independent media who are calling me and telling me, hey, viruses don't exist and PCR testing doesn't work. Like, come on, give me a break. I run a science lab, okay? I've run PCR equipment. You can use it to test for bacteria in food. I can take a food sample, I can put it in the machine, and in 30 hours it tells me whether there's horse protein in there, okay? How does that work? Because horse DNA is replicated by the PCR technology, and then it's analyzed and sequenced in the software, and it can tell me, hey, there's horse protein in there. The technology's real, folks. Don't be flat earthers on this, okay? Don't be like the flat earth version of virology to say there's no viruses. Okay, viruses are real. PCR technology works, and as I've stated before, the earth is a sphere. So we have to start with some really basic things in order to tackle the reality that's hitting us right now. And whether Owen Schroyer has a slightly different view, or Alex Jones has a different view, or myself, Mike Adams, has a different view, or Gary Haven, what we all care about is saving America, helping Trump win and conquer this and beat this thing, restoring the republic, conserving civil liberties, and defeating the deep state criminals, the traitors, the child pedophiles on the left, the corrupt criminal cartels of the Clintons and the Bidens and the Obamas. We have to defeat that. But they have laid a vicious trap for Trump right now with this virus, a vicious trap. And if Trump doesn't navigate this very, very carefully and decisively and quickly, Trump will be destroyed by this. And Gary Haven agrees with my assessment on that and thinks Trump has only a week to take decisive action. Now, what will that action be? We're going to talk to Stuart Rhodes on the other side of this break about maybe what Trump could do right now that doesn't violate our constitutional rights. Because if we beat the virus but we end up enslaved under tyranny, that's no solution either. How do we beat the virus and save our republic and save Trump and still have a Second Amendment? We'll find out after this break with Stuart Rhodes. Stay with us. This is Mike Adams here on the Alex Jones Show.